I am researching what dragonflies do in the winter. How do they survive when it gets really, really cold? By learning about dragonflies and how they live underwater in winter, I'm learning a lot about water quality in general and how it affects the entire ecosystem. I'm looking at one species of dragonfly called the common green darner, but there are many types of dragonflies that overwinter under the ice. When you are digging through the net, through the mud, and the plants looking for a nymph, it smells like summer.
I found one.
It has that muddy, earthy smell as if you were walking on a trail on a wet spring day. On this day, we found two different species. One of them was the common green darner, and the other one we found was the Canada darner.
Grab their food. They got these little hooks on the ends of there, and a bunch of teeth inside there, and then their mandibles are actually up under here.
It's got one more molt to go before it can merge.
We collect those nymphs, and I bring them back into the lab. In the lab, I can measure them to figure out what part of their life stage they are in. And I can tell that by measuring their head. And I also measure what we call their wing pads or their wing sheaths, which are tiny little bumps on their back, which will become their wings when they become adults. Your hands get wet when you are looking through the mud and the plants for the nymphs.
Yeah, you got swoop, man.
Yeah,
you got our best swooper right there.
Usually, I'm so excited about what I'm doing that I don't notice that my hands are cold. I have many people that help me when I'm out in the field. I have volunteers who are from the Minnesota Dragonfly Society. And I also have volunteers that work with me in my lab at the University of Minnesota. Many people are really excited about learning about dragonflies.